finished line art. This is the really the main thing to do. Finished line art is what the cartoon is all about. Then coloring it is easy, although I've got a lot of characters in here to color. So thank you for joining me again. And again, apologies for the break, but I like for these things to not run over 2 hours. And gotta take a break every couple hours. And readjust everything. Everything seems to want to be readjusted every couple of hours. Thank you for following, Tom Meyer. I appreciate that. I do need the follows. So I'm just going to start drawing from right to left because I'm left-handed. And I rethink everything as I draw. I haven't quite figured out how Bernie's jacket's gonna work here. He needs the arm up wrinkles. If you wonder what I'm doing over here to the right, I have a little piece of sandpaper over to the right that I use to get my chisel points on my pencils the way I like them. So did I lose everybody online when I took that time off? I'm not seeing any number count. Oh, here's a comment on YouTube. Do you ever vote for the most cartoonable candidate rather than the one you think would do a better job? You know, I don't. And likewise, I don't do the cheap gags bashing people if I'm not inclined to bash them. Which you might take note of regarding Donald Trump this year, because I have been unusually light in my Donald Trump criticism, just because I'm just thinking that those other Republicans are so much worse that people don't take Donald Trump in perspective with his colleagues. Donald Trump needs to get better credit for not being as much of a religious nut as his Republican competitors. Which is the big thing that worries me. So, Dawifa writes, you're brave mixing live chat and politics. Have you banned a lot of people? I think I've banned 3 or 4. But they didn't want to argue about politics. They just wanted to say 4-letter words. For no particular political reason that I can discern. So no, I haven't been having much political chat issue here. In fact, I notice different from my email inbox, which is full of people who disagree with me, is Twitch has more of a how-to attitude. More like aspiring cartoonists or people that are more interested in asking questions about drawing than arguing politics. Which is something I hadn't really considered, but it is very much a different audience than the Cagle.com audience that has people coming and just looking at cartoons for content, editorial cartoons for content. Switch camera, please. Oh, boy, I certainly did that. Sorry about that, and thank you for letting me know, Dawifa. I have too many things on my mind, so if you notice me missing something, thank you for speaking up. Because I will miss things. Okay. And thank you, Psy Matrix, for letting me know as well. Psy Matrix, who is my computer genius who makes Cagle.com run, was beeping me on my phone to change cameras. So, thank you for that, Psy. Part of the problem, you know, is that I'm delayed by 2 or 3 minutes. When you hear me talking, it's what I said 2 or 3 minutes ago. But I do get your chat in real time. So I get it in real time, I respond to it in real time, and you don't see it for hear it for 2 or 3 minutes. So. Awkward. I do get a lot of comments here from people who think that I should draw faster. Oh, that was BBC. Chris Christie has just dropped out of the race. As he should have, I think. BBC alerts on my phone. That's what you just heard. So much for Chris Christie. I didn't care much for drawing Chris Christie. So just as well. He strikes me as an angry guy. Oh, Cy Matrix is telling me that Fiorina also dropped out. I missed that. Was that just a few minutes ago? I would say that my two least favorite candidates in the presidential race were Fiorina and Huckabee. And so it is nice to see them both drop out. Ted Cruz, you might think that I would think Ted Cruz is just god-awful monster. But he's fun to draw and he amuses me. And I like how he speaks. He's really quite clever and he comes out with stuff on the fly that I enjoy. So politically, I would think he was awful, but as a cartoonist, I do enjoy him. Donald Trump is great for me as a cartoonist as well, but he is so tangibly better than Cruz that I have purposefully decided not to be too mean to him, unlike the other cartoonists who draw him as Hitler and stuff. Cy Matrix says Carson is probably next. That would be interesting. Although, when a bunch of people drop out, it looks a little nominally better for the ones who have not yet dropped out. So perhaps things are brighter for Carson. Anyway, I think I'm safe with today's cartoon with Bernie and Hillary. So one problem I have in here is that my room has big windows, and as the light changes through the day, so too do the settings for my cameras need to change. I haven't quite figured out how to deal with that issue without clumsily saying, reswitching the stream, give me a minute. This will be three streams. This being part two of three, and it will be finishing this line art, and then part three of three will be the color in Photoshop. So, Kid Scoop News. When drawing random people such as this cartoon's crowd scene, do you use reference or just make up the faces from your imagination? I make them up. I only use reference when I have something that's gonna be wrong if I don't draw it precisely that way. So I use reference for Hillary and Bernie's faces and for this Corinthian column. I could have looked up what Cupids look like, but Cupid came out of my head. Well, thank you for the question, Kid Scoop News. I'm sorry I missed you there because you're on YouTube. Kid Scoop News writes, speaking of candidates dropping out, have you ever been midway through a cartoon or just finished one and breaking news renders it obsolete? Oh, yes! Not an infrequent occurrence. Also, sometimes I'll do a wonderful drawing and a big news story will come on. And then my nice cartoon is worthless because nobody wants that cartoon. They all want the big news story. I'm forgetting just what the cartoon was, but not long ago when they had that Bataclan terrorist attack in Paris, I had just done an excellent Donald Trump cartoon. Oh, it was Donald Trump immigration cartoon. I drew him with Pepe Gonzalez as a Warner Brothers Looney Tunes cartoon. And I don't think that cartoon got printed at all because everybody was talking about the terror stuff in Paris and Donald Trump and immigration just got lost. But I quite liked that cartoon. I think it got printed nowhere and it was kind of provocative. I'll show it to you. See, you ask a question, you get such a good answer. Let's bring that up. So I'm going to go to politicalcartoons.com. I'll show you this cartoon that I thought was good, but nobody ever printed it, I think, because MP. Let's look for Daryl and search. Was this one. This cartoon. Donald Trump with three Sylvesters and Pepe Gonzalez calling him a nasty word in Spanish. Pendejo. I liked that cartoon. Nobody printed it because it was on my drawing board getting finished right at the time the Paris attacks started taking over the news. So, a critical of Donald Trump cartoon that nobody sees. And there you see it a little bit bigger. Anyway, enough of that. You asked a question about a cartoon that overtaken by the news, and there you go. Some news is so loud it drowns out all the other news, and there's no point drawing anything else because it's just not going to get printed. Happens alarmingly frequently. So folks, please do follow. I appreciate the follows. I need the follows. There's 33 of you here. That's enough of you to have some people that need a follow. Yeah, Kid Scoop News, I gave you an extra good answer to that one, huh? And a good cartoon that nobody saw. I couldn't even plug it on my own site because we had to devote the site to the Paris attacks. That cartoon got ignored everywhere, including from me. Okay, back to Bernie's face. And, you know, again, in case you're wondering, here's Bernie. That's what I'm looking at the screen in front of me. Have I drawn cartoons about TPP or TTIP? Right, Sprudelel. Well, tell me more, Sprudelel. What is the TTP, TTIP of which you speak? I suspect it's a Euro thing. Kid Scoop News writes, I'd save the Speedy Gonzalez cartoon. Long campaign and Trump is sure to go there again sooner or later. Well, it's there. But, you know, it's It's a process. That cartoon has already been delivered. People want fresh for the next one. So I think that cartoon has just suffered from unfortunate timing. Donald Trump got off easy on that one because I haven't drawn much criticism of Donald Trump. That was a critical Donald Trump cartoon. And I liked that cartoon. So sometimes I'm quite frustrated by things not getting reprinted. Trade partnerships deals. TTIP is the European version. We're having a lot of discussion here about the Asian trade deal. I forget the acronym for that. But I'm not really familiar with the European trade deal. I can tell you that foreign trade is quite the hassle for me in my little syndicate business. The tax rules and the filing requirements, really a pain in the butt. So folks, you 32 folks that are watching, please do follow me. I need the follows. Those follows have dried up. No follow for a half an hour. Sprudel writes, in Germany, for example, they're taking extreme measures to keep the contents of it secret. Well, bastards. That's one of Donald Trump's big talking points. He loves to talk about how bad the trade deals are. You should see the tax forms I have to do for the foreign cartoonists in our group. Just bloody hell. And it costs as much to fill out the forms as it does and tax that's getting withheld. And the cartoonists just are incensed. You're taking American taxes out of my money. I don't want to pay America taxes. I don't like America. I'm sorry, cartoonists, but I must follow the law. To which angry banter follows. Okay, Barney. Oh, Pigeon Schilt. I'm glad you love this Pigeon Schilt. Have you followed me? Because I need the follows. I suspect many of you watch without committing to follow. And think about how terrible that is for a minute. That's just terrible. Oh, thank you, Pigeon. Oh, you did just now. Thank you. I appreciate it. Okay, I'm going to have to draw Bernie's face, aren't I? I've been kind of procrastinating that. You can tell the way that I draw. I need to go from right to left just because I'm left-handed, but I procrastinate as much as I can. Okay, Bernie. In case you're wondering, I've got a big glass of pencils over here. My tech genius, Psy Matrix, has talked me into sharpening all of my pencils when I'm not live streaming. One of the many new skills I have to learn from the streaming experience. Don't sharpen your pencils. I also used to watch Talking Heads on TV all day long as I drew. And I feel like I'm a bit detached from some of the news by doing this drawing without the sound on. Well, without the sound on the TV. Pigeon loves Bernie. That's nice. Alright, Bernie. Bernie has this interesting nose that is the anchor for his face. People think of his hair and top of his head as the anchor, but it is not. It is his interesting nose. And the nose is asymmetrical and kind of odd and thinner from the front than it is from the side. And you can't really draw it the way it looks because you got to get the feel of it rather than the actuality of it. Let's see if I like that for a while. These lines that come down from your nose to the sides of your mouth are called pillars. Cartoonists put a lot of stock into pillars. We think a lot about pillars. So anyway, thank you again, Pigeon, for following. I appreciate it. Got his nose looking a little funky here, but it has a sense of kind of being right. So I'm not sure I want to muck with it. He does get this. Interesting lower lip stuff going on. That is fun. I enjoy the lower lip. Jazzy606 writes, did drawing come to you naturally or did you really have to work at it? I'm afraid you really have to work at it, Jazzy. I've just been drawing for years and years and, you know, I find that most of my cartoonist colleagues have a kind of a similar background of getting into this, which is we all collected comic books and drew superheroes. And I think that's true of guys my age, but I don't think it's true of kids getting into cartooning these days, because where when I was a kid, we collected comic books. Now kids don't do that. They play games. And you're not sitting drawing all the time when you're a gamer. So a lot of those many hours spent behind a pencil are just not something that happens with kids these days. Yeah, Bernie is fun. I like Bernie. Alright, I've got to get his left eye right. What is... his left eye is bigger than the right eye. Oh, so Pigeon, you do collect comics and spend all your time drawing. Good. That's what you need to do. And I find that it doesn't really matter what you draw. Well, I shouldn't say that. It's fine for you to be drawing comics, because that'll help you to draw absolutely anything. Naked people in spandex is your door to drawing anything in the world. Dawifa writes, did you meet Jim Henson? If so, any stories? Well, you know, I worked for the Muppets from about 1978 through about 1993, and I was right out of college in 78. I moved to Manhattan to seek my fortune as an illustrator. And in those days, there were no fax machines. There was no Federal Express. I think my Bernie's looking kind of good. And so to be a credible illustrator, you had to live in Manhattan. And so I moved to Manhattan, and I started carrying my portfolio around to places in 1978. And I did a whole bunch of beginning illustrator kind of work. Did a lot of work for Scholastic. I did books. And pretty quick there, the Muppets picked me up as a favored Muppet illustrator. And they actually kept me fully booked doing Pigs and Frogs in Sesame Street for about 15 years. They actually had somebody there whose responsibility it was to make sure that Daryl did not sit idle, that he always had some Muppets to draw. So I was a freelancer working at home, but they booked every hour, which was just wonderful. I bought a house in Connecticut. And the Muppets were great. And the whole reason was that Jim Henson liked the way I drew Muppets. And I would see him once in a while because I'd go into the townhouse. And he always had a kind, generic thing to say. Oh, hello, Daryl. Love the way you draw those Muppets. Lots of action. And they would invite me to something like the Christmas party, and Jim Henson was there, and he would come over and say, nice to see you, Daryl. Love the way you draw those Muppets. And that was pretty much the only conversation I ever had with him, which was exchanging pleasantries. He would say, love what you're doing, Daryl. And I would say, oh, Mr. Henson, I'm such a fan. You're so wonderful. Thank you for everything. And he'd say, woo, 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 woo. So I don't have any other Jim Henson stories than that. That was the complete story of my relationship with Jim Henson. There was a fellow at the Muppets named Michael Frith in those days, who used to work with Dr. Seuss, and he is just absolutely brilliant. He was their creative director through the 80s, and I was very impressed with him. And he was in charge of all of the projects that I would have been working on, since he was the creative director. And then there were art directors under him that I also worked with. And everybody at the Muppets were just charming and delightful. Wonderful 15 years. Made my career for me. Yeah, I think I've got Bernie looking good here. So, Pigeon writes that he draws little comics about monsters. Well, I say he. I don't know. Your name is in pink. And kids have their own individual monster who follows them everywhere. Well, very good. Kind of a Monsters, Inc. thing. Bernie. Kind of pleased with my Bernie. I think he's looking okay. can see that I'm not actually tracing, I'm actually redrawing everything. Quite a few of you here are online. I mean, quite a few people online here. I think 30 some. And what have I got on? What? 4 people on YouTube. That's a good batch. You guys should be talking more. And thank you for your helpful advice, Theo. I would be lost without Psi Matrix here. Hello, Wonderboy 420. Well, I've got too much work in his hair so that it's not looking gray enough. So I've got to take something out. Gray it up. So, Psi Matrix, old buddy, I don't understand that about lurking. Hello, TisBeast111. Nice to see you here again. I do remember you, but you have to remind me who you are. Remembering people from their screen names is not yet a strength of mine. Thank you, TisBeast. Hey, Funky Monkey! Nice to see you back, Funky Monkey! So today's cartoon is a Valentine's Day cartoon. And it is about Bernie being more popular with young female voters than Hillary, much more so. And Hillary and her angry old feminist supporters like Gloria Steinem and Madeleine Albright find this behavior among the young ladies to be very disappointing and annoying. Funky Monkey writes, "How are you? I'm doing great, Funky. I'm starting to get the hang of the streaming, and I do appreciate Twitch. I like the whole idea of this. I'm hoping to make it work. It's a journey. Tisbeast, the kid from England. Very good. Yes, I do remember you, TisBeast. All right, more drawing all this crowd of girls. This is actually quite an ambitious cartoon for all these characters and caricatures that I've got in it. I usually like to draw cartoons that just have a one or two little characters in them. And there's kind of a general rule in cartooning that if the cartoon is complex and you put a lot of stuff in it, like I was complaining earlier about crowd scenes, then the cartoon is lousy. Simpler cartoons are better. And that's something I was never able to successfully explain to art directors during my years as an illustrator. Because they don't approach the cartoon as what's better. They approach it as, does it meet this list of needs that I have from the committee? No, you can't talk to the committee. The committee already decided what they want. It's tough to be an illustrator. One thing that is so lovely about what I do is I've developed this little syndicate business that allows me to draw what I want when I want. Although drawing it when I want is starting to be a question now if I need to schedule for Twitch. The Weaver writes, if Hillary was singing a song as she stands there, what would she be singing? I don't know what to tell you. This is a Valentine. And I'm not a music guy. His Beast writes, am I spamming? Why do you ask that? You seem to be a polite young man. Weaver writes, a 70s song all by myself? Oh, that's sad. So just so you know, this stuff does take a while, and I'm going to be here probably another 2.5 hours working on this pup. Tis Beast writes, thank you, you're a very nice person with awesome talent. Oh, thank you. Funky Monkey writes, I have to go to bed. Just want to drop in and say hi. I might pop in later on my iPad. Thank you, Funky Monkey. I appreciate your coming by. I don't think I like that girl's face. I think she needs different bottom half of the mouth. See you later, Funky Monkey. Oh, Moonja 619, thank you so much for following. I do appreciate it. His Beast writes, when are you next streaming? I haven't got the next stream planned because I'm going away for the weekend. But I'm going to try to keep a better and more regular schedule going forward. And you should be able to see my schedule on Cagle.com when it is finalized on the front page. But for now, the plan is going forward after this weekend when I'm away that I should be drawing Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday at noon at the least. Tisbeast writes, why does chat have a delay for you? And sorry for spelling. I'm nine. You're 9 years old, Tisbeast? That's funny. Chat doesn't have a delay for me, but you have a delay in hearing my voice response. So I see the chat right away, but you don't hear me respond to the chat for a couple of minutes because of just the process that it takes for the stream to wind its way through the internet from me to you through Twitch. I'm not sure I like her. I'm going to leave her there for a little bit while I work on something else. Okay. Oh, our audience is dwindling. I'll try to pick up the pace here. Too many people in Europe going to sleep, I suspect. Now it has no delays, says Tis Beast. I'm not sure what to suggest for you, Tis Beast. I do see as I'm looking here that it doesn't look like too bad a delay. Probably more like 20 or 30 seconds. 10:51 in England. Excellent time to be watching drawings. Oh, Z-Human, thank you so much for following, Z-Human. And Moonjet619, thank you again. I don't think I should worry too much about taking too much time for this, because I look at some of these other people on Twitch Creative, and it's like they just turn on the camera and it's all day, every day. Which is fine. And I treat it more as finish a discrete drawing in each session. I like to have a beginning, middle, and end. You got school tomorrow, tis beast. Oh, look how her hand is on completely backwards. Because I wasn't thinking as I drew this. I did this hand as holding the camera. So this hand has to go this direction. Tisby, so yes, tell everybody, get everybody watching my stream. I need more people watching the stream, so thank you. Sorry for spam? Yes, no spam. Everything's good. By and large, people here are quite polite. Right, her phone. There, cover up that awkward thumb. We've got 33 people watching. That's nice. You need to be more vocal, folks. Give me some chat. See you later, PSI Matrix. Tisbeast writes, do you have Twitter? Yes. Nightbox just posted my Twitter, at DCagle. Oh, and Psy Matrix, please change the widest syndicated editorial cartoonist to the most widely syndicated editorial cartoonist. I am wide, but I'm not sure I should proclaim my width. So, most widely syndicated. This gal's nose is wrong. That's better. I'm not as good with Twitter as I should be. Although I did post a recent cartoon. Oh, back over on YouTube, which I need to watch as well. Mark Robinson writes, I tried using very dark pencil instead of pen and ink, but I wasn't satisfied with the end result. It looks great when you do it, though. Well, you have to draw hard. And I naturally draw hard, so it's not an issue. But lots of people don't have that natural proclivity. They like to draw soft, the soft gray lines from the pencil, which do not work. Kid Scoop News writes, Bernie looks perfect. Not sure if I like his wild hair or the way you drew his mouth best. Oh, well. Perfection. Excuse me. When these girls get done, I need to move Cupid to be a little different position. Jazzy606 writes, what's one thing you would say someone who is just starting to get into drawing should try to get down to improve? Well, there are some things that people look for. The most important thing, I think, is value your work highly and present it in a professional way. And then look for those tells that you know people use to quickly judge you. And try to avoid doing some of those amateur tells. So don't use a computer font with your cartoons. And don't avoid drawing hands and feet. One surefire way to spot a aspiring cartoonist is he doing the pocket hand tricks and hiding hands in pockets or behind backs, avoiding drawing hands, drawing feet poorly, or avoiding drawing feet. Focus on those things that, you know, in art school you gotta get right. And then love drawing and prove it by spending time with your drawing. Another thing that amateurs do a lot is they don't spend much time on their drawings. They zip through real fast. And you should love what you're doing enough to want to spend time with it. So those are leading tells. Tisbeast writes, what's the hard part about drawing? Many things are harder to draw than others. I don't know that there's a particular hard part. Different people like different things. You'll notice that some things are harder for me and they just take longer. Particular hard part. Interesting though, the chat that I get here is how to chat about how to draw rather than people complaining about the politics. So quite a different audience here on Twitch. Very much the how to aspiring artist audience. Tisbeast writes, I like in the background there's a kid angle that's sticking out his tongue. Oh, that's Cupid. He's giving the raspberry to Hillary. That's the gag here. A kid. This is Valentine's Day here. Cartoon Man writes, when I was a little kid, they showed an artist drawing Mickey Mouse on Wonderful World of Disney. The artist drew him really, really fast. For years, I couldn't understand why I couldn't draw that fast, no matter how much I tried. Saw the footage again a few years ago and realized it was sped up footage. Actually, I think the videos of my doing this stuff are better when you watch them at 1.5 speed. We can afford to be sped up. I listen to my podcasts at 1.5 speed. The Talking Heads pundits are better when they're sped up as well. So many details, so many girls. This beast writes, where are the other 35 views? Let's see what I got. I've got 27 people on Twitch and 3 people on YouTube, so I've got 30. One of them is probably me watching myself. Ibarra, you're lurking! Ikibara, be sure to follow me. I need the follows. Even if you're just lurking. Right, there's her hand holding her cell phone. Oh, thank you, Kibara. Clueless male is multitasking. Well, you know, this is kind of a good thing to have on while you're multitasking. I would like to have a lot of my favorite cartoonists do this, and I would leave a window open on their drawing board all day long. It would be lovely to have a view of the drawing boards of your favorite cartoonists, wouldn't it? I need to do a little work on Bernie's Corinthian column. Ibarra writes, debating starting streaming myself, but people are in a meeting in the same room, so it might not be a good idea. Her neck is not looking good. Give her a little bit more thoughtful jawline. That's better. So although I'm making all this up, I do think of things like, you know, composition and light source and all of that stuff as I go along. I'm thinking of my reference points to anatomy as I'm drawing these characters, making sure their proportions are right. Clueless Mail writes, I work from home, so I almost always twitch open to someone unless I'm presenting a WebEx. Okay. Got to do this Corinthian column, don't I? Okay, Corinthian column. Oh, and thank you for following Tisbeast and also Soft Top. Thank you both. I appreciate that. So, just in case you're wondering, this is the scene that I'm looking at on my monitor. To do Bernie's Corinthian column. Yes, those guys on YouTube. What the heck are they doing over there? Okay, Bunny. Yes, I use reference. So, sorry to sit quiet. You know, it's not natural to chat all the time while I draw. I'm used to sitting quietly. Cartoon Man writes, when political cartoonists get together, do they tend to talk about the process of cartooning or more about current events and politics? Well, it depends on the get-together. But I would say they talk more about process. They talk more about business issues. At least with me, they do. Okay, Corinthian columns. Well, I need a little more crosshatch in that. I can procrastinate a little bit more on my Corinthian columns. So, Mr. Sanders has real people liking him, but Clinton has super delegates loving her. Well, that's true. It's gonna be hard to get past those super delegates. They could just rewrite the rules to the convention if Bernie wins. If Hillary is self-destructing, could happen. They could yank it away from him. That would make people plenty mad. Thank you. All right, Corinthian column. Tis Beast writes, do you watch football or you call soccer? I do not. I have no interest in soccer. Sorry about that. I know that's a harsh thing to say to a kid in England. Nice to not offend you there. Tis Beast. Corinthian column. That's too far to the left. Yeah, time for you to go to bed, Tis Beast. This late night show is just too late. Good night. Come back next time. Thank you for following. Thank you for the kind words, Tis Beast. You can see how hard I draw on this hard pencil. Bites and chips. Yinny, JB, thank you for following. I appreciate it. That's very nice of you. silly Corinthian column. I'm not sure it looks like anything. Looks like the photo scrap. Dawifa writes, do you use anything besides a post-it note to capture cartoon ideas that come to mind? I use a voice recorder, great to use while driving or doing other things where I can't write it down. I draw on a napkin at when I go out to eat sometimes. But no, I have not established a good regimen for cartoon ideas. No notebook. As many cartoonists do notebooks, I know. But I have never developed that regimen. Tennis shoes here. I've thought about doing a short video on how to draw feet. I did one on how to draw hands. People worry more about their hands. Cartoon Man, is there going to be a caption on this one? No caption and no labels. You see all you need to see. Try to avoid captions and labels wherever I can. There's kind of poetry to editorial cartooning if you can avoid the words. A cartoon with no words is worth more than a wordy cartoon. So I strive to do the cartoons that have no words. Oh, good. You like not having a caption, huh? Captions are for sissies. And as you can imagine, I'm still going to be here quite a bit longer. This one will, this one is a complex one. It'll take a while. So my last follower is Yenny B. And I need another one. So if you haven't followed, please follow. The Weaver writes, is the term sissy outdated as it sounds rather girly man and could offend some groups? Maybe so. I haven't put any thought into that. Should I discontinue the use of that offensive term, particularly as I'm drawing young women? One thing's kind of interesting about cartooning is that you typically draw a lot more men than you draw women. And cartoonists are criticized for that. But you know, if you draw a man, nobody asks, why'd you make him a man? If you draw a woman, people do ask, why did you make her a woman? What are you saying about women by drawing her? And, so unless you want to make a statement about a woman, typically you're safer not drawing a woman, which ends up meaning that there are fewer cartoons with women in them. Not the effect I think cartoonists want when they make that choice. DeWeefa writes, I'm not the word police. When you said it, it just struck me funny, and I wanted to see what you would say. Okay. Now, this young lady is also holding her cell phone. Thank you. He's on his pedestal. His Corinthian pedestal. DeWifa writes, glad to see you put in the cell phones for selfies. When you took the suggestion, it made my day. Ah, well, that was an excellent suggestion. And so I owe all of these cell phones to you, DeWifa. You know, there is more pressure in drawing live and having people watch everything and having all my mistakes on display. I do make lots of mistakes. So here, I've been drawing for an hour and a half since I started this part two of the stream after drawing 2 hours to do the rough sketch. Oh, let's use that again. So this one is quite the ambitious cartoon. But I don't think it's unreasonable that a cartoon should take all day. Of course a cartoon should take all day. This cartoon is in that it has more work and thought in it, and I'm spinning it around more than I do on a usual cartoon. I'm getting more dirty fingerprints on it than usual, too. DeWifa writes, what types of topics did you foresee people chatting with you about before you started the live drawings? I thought the chat would be more like my email box, which is not at all a how-to kind of thing, but more discussion of the politics. You liberal bastard. You Obama lover. I think I'm going to have to move up and do Cupid now. Just moving that far to the left. Next thing on the list. This one needs a little afternoon. Cartoon Man writes, who do you think will ultimately be the DNC and RNC candidates? I don't know. That's what makes this process interesting, huh? That we don't know? I think there's a good chance that we could end up with something strange going on. Brokered conventions. So I just don't know what to tell you. So Michael Bloomberg says he's going to run if Bernie is nominated, huh? That would be interesting. I kind of like Michael Bloomberg. All right, Cupid. Oh, I'm tearing everything up. Where should Cupid go? Cupid goes. Is that much up? Is that all Cupid needs? A little bit up more. Break out the kneaded eraser because this is getting kind of dirty. I usually don't work this dirty. But lots of overworking today with too many characters and a caricature. I'm just getting dirty. I'm going to clean it up. Tawifa writes, do I own originals from other cartoonists? Oh, yes, cartoonists trade, and I buy art from other cartoonists. So, yeah, that's something you do when you're a cartoonist. Fill the house with other people's cartoons. What? Hand is dirty. Adding a little more ill-defined feet and things in the background, because we know there's more stuff going back there, going on back there. I just have not yet dealt with it. Right, Cupid. His tongue needs to be funnier than it is. Let's get to that. Okay, Cupid. See if I like that. Not quite sure I do. Hair's looking kind of silly. I don't think that's gonna last. Maybe a snarky smile on Cupid. Remember, he's doing this. So, do you smile while you do that? Not sure. Cupid-y. Going with your smile suggestion here, Dawifa. I think that is better. Hello, Cymatrix. Nice to see you back. I miss you when you're gone. He's saying to Hillary. Look how I've run down the pencils. A lot fewer pencils here than when I started. Note that I've been sharpening in advance. This little Cupid hand. The Phoebe writes, now this is pro. Oh, and you followed. Thank you, the Phoebe. That was very nice of you. I do appreciate the follows. Cupid's looking kind of funny. I'm not dissatisfied with Cupid. Bottom lip's a little wrong. Fix that. Oh, I use up my erasers. I get all these pencils with no erasers, one after the other. I should throw away the yellow pencil when I've used up the pink eraser. But I don't, because I think, well, the rest of this pencil is perfectly good. Then it's just trouble because it has no eraser. Oh, the Phoebe! I'm getting filled in on how you're an excellent pro artist. And so I do appreciate your stopping in. I'm new to Twitch and just getting used to the regimen of all of this, which is a very different culture. And a little bit scary, I think, to put live work out there. So, I admire what you do. You're a pioneer. There's this little pooty foot. Are you guys bothered by this blue overlay? I'm getting a couple comments about that. I put it there so that it reduces the green screen issues on my head, and I figured you're not looking at anything here because nothing ever happens here. This is where my hand goes. But I could eliminate it if you want. Like that. I'm not sure that's better. I think I like it better with the blue slop there. Gives a little sense of anchoring the thing on the left. The Phoebe writes, pretty sure I could watch you do this all day and not have to draw myself. I'm getting the same satisfaction. Ah! Thank you, the Phoebe. Yes, I very much like the idea of Twitch Creative and the idea of looking in on people's drawing tables. It would be great if lots of top cartoonists would do this, and I'm just the only editorial cartoonist I think that is even trying this. But it's new, you know, and it requires some shaking up of old notions. Gotta be willing to put yourself out there and make some mistakes. And let everybody see. Well, thank you, Dawifa. Dawifa is fine with the blue on the left. Doesn't really cover anything up. You can still see the stuff through there. I could lighten it up if it's bothering you. I'm getting some comments on the blue. There, the blue is lighter. Is that better? Can you see through it better? lighter. I'm still changing things a little bit each time as I get more used to this stuff and figure things out. The Phoebe writes, I think the overlay is great. The meat of the project is in the clear area, and we can still see what's happening behind. You could also graduate it to more transparent as it grows up. I think since I've got the comments and the stats and things in my head over there on the left, that it needs... it looks like my camera for my head has frozen. That's bad. Think about how to deal with that. Give this a try. I think that worked. I unplugged it and plugged it back in, and then I lost all of my camera settings, didn't I? It makes me look too washed out. Yeah, it is. OBS is not Mac friendly, and let me fix my camera settings. I'm sorry. I'm gonna have to get a little better at these things. Show panel brightness down. That's the wrong camera. Brightness down. Oh, there I am. I've come back. Okay, I think we're good. There, just my settings. Thank you, the Phoebe. It sounds like the Phoebe that you I've gotten comfortable with all these things that happen, whereas I'm still encountering them for the first time. So I apologize for my awkwardness. Excelsior. Psy Matrix, sounds like you're a Marvel guy. I was more of a DC kid. All right, he needs wings, and I didn't leave much room for his wings because his razzing is where his wings should go. Let's see if that works. Is he still razzing well enough through the wing? I see no good reason for a camera to freeze. What the hell? Why would the camera freeze? We're working fine for hours. Cartoon Man writes, do you ever sneak in caricatures of people you know in crowd scenes? I have done that. The Phoebe writes, I keep hearing good, bad stuff about DH. I don't know DH. DH. Okay, the back of his, the little feathery back of his arrow didn't work the way I drew it. And must be rethought. The arm could have a little bit of shade. This has to come back. That looks a little better. DH, Dark Horse. Oh! You know, I'm an old bastard. I was out of comics before Dark Horse even started. I tell my son I had every X-Men comic. And I did. And then I had a fire and the house burned down and all my comics burned down. I should tell him I had more exotic things than I actually had. Because there's no disproving it. Weefa writes, who is my favorite superhero? Oh, I like the Silver Surfer. I like the John Buscema Silver Surfer. You know, I appreciate Jack Kirby. And I know he's the big star, but I was just a big John Buscema fan. I loved the way he drew. Not a lot of room for Hillary here. She could be up a little. Well, and put a foot in her head. That's kind of funny. I don't think I want to do that. But it's kind of funny. She could come down and be a little bit in the foreground. What do I want to do with her? I'm running out of room on the edge of my drawing. I think she should go there. Put her there. So, yes, I like the John Buscema Silver Surfer. I think he doesn't get the credit he deserves in the Marvel Universe. Big Buscema fan. The Phoebe writes, you likely get asked this a lot. Is that Duralar you're drawing on? Yes, Duraline! Forget the names of the others that are similar, but it's not tracing paper. It is, seems to. No, it's a vellum, and it's a plastic vellum. So I can't get too nasty on it. It stands up to anything. And yes, Duraline from Seth Cole. And I love Duraline. Because it has this wonderful grippy texture for the pencil line that allows me to do this hard pencil line that looks like ink and really isn't ink, so that I have the freedom and the comfort of not having to commit to ink. And then I will just scan this at high contrast, it'll look like ink, and everybody will say, but Daryl, I thought you drew in ink, and I do not. I think the Phoebe sounds like you've got, you sound like you're quite the pro, you've got all this stuff figured out. I've never had anybody look at my feed on here and say, is that Duraline you're using? It absolutely is. And that's kind of impressive. All right, Hillary. Just in case you're wondering, this is what I'm looking at on the screen in front of me. I'm looking at Hillary. Oh, it looks like the camera's moving around. Put that back. The Phoebe writes, I'll have to find that. Not familiar with it. Love drawing on Duralar. If it's anything like that, I'm excited to try it. I think, is Duralar the white vellum instead of the clear vellum? But I think it's the same outfit. It might be the same stuff. I like the clear because I want to look at my drawing behind it, and the white stuff is pretty opaque, although it's also lovely stuff to draw on. But I find that when you put a piece of white paper behind the clear Duraline, that it looks just lovely as original art. I'll come in and clean up these little fingerprints with a kneaded eraser, and this would be a great piece of original art. All right, Hillary. Oh, and thank you for following the feed. I appreciate that. Yenny JB writes, they have vellum in many different colors as well as just different opacity versions of white. I didn't know that. That's interesting. Well, I do just love the surface quality, and I love that it's so sturdy. You saw how I was breaking through the paper when I was doing the rough sketch. Never happens with Duraline. This stuff is serious. It's indestructible. Cartoon Man writes, are your originals ever made available for sale? Yeah, I'll sell the originals. I sell them every so often. So Yenny JB, are you drawing on Duraline too? There, she's got some consternation going on. I'm happy with that. That's good. Good, good. Oh, not looking enough at YouTube. Kid Scoop News writes, Bernie looks perfect. Not sure if I like his wild hair or the way you drew his mouth best. Well, what you gonna do? NEGB writes, I used to, using the vellum back when I had time to draw in college, I'd mostly use it while doing gesture drawings or multi-layer perspective pieces. Well, they claim that it's archive quality and it's supposed to last forever. And to my experience, it does seem to last. I like the idea of stuff being archive quality, last forever, indestructible. I'm not sure if I like this, Hillary. I'm going to leave her there for a few minutes and see how she percolates on me. Ubi Games writes, how long have you been drawing? Oh, I started drawing when I was a little kid. As most cartoonists do. think I don't like her nose. Cymatrix writes, does the Duraline take shading well or just hard line pencil? Yes, if I drew in a lighter pencil and I wanted to do shading on it, it would deal with that fine. But I think if I wanted to do that, I would choose a different kind of paper. Probably draw on a Bristol or something. So, I think this is well suited to the particular thing that I'm doing with it. And, perhaps different materials for different things. I wouldn't paint on Duraline, and I think of it only for line art. But it makes a nice original for line art. Judas Mata, thank you for the nice, kind words, Judas Mata. You must follow me. Oh, and thank you, Ubi Games. Got another nice follow from Ubi Games. I appreciate that. Oh, we've got 92 people watching. They must have put me back in the top spot. Cymatrix, can you take a look? Am I back in the top spot? Is that why we have 96 people watching? I'm not happy with her nose yet, so let's... think about her nose again. Oh, I'm on the Jumbotron. Good, good, good. Dawifa writes, if a cartoonist wanted to be syndicated by you, how would they start the process? Well, you can always submit samples. I can tell you that the problem with syndication is it doesn't pay much. And everybody wants to do it because that's how you get to be, get to have your cartoons be a part of the public debate. So even if you've got a little client somewhere, or even a big client somewhere, it's your cartoons in syndication that people are going to see around the country and around the world. And people do this because they want to have a voice in the public debate. That's what makes it fun. That's why you choose to do an underpaid profession where everybody just gets mad at you. And the people who like what you do tend to stay silent. So, you know, understandably, there are a lot of people who want to do this who just, there's just not enough space in the profession. And the clients we have are not asking for more content. Because there are already plenty of cartoonists vying for that one spot on the page every day. So, it's tough. And the biggest problem we have when we take on someone who's new, who's unfamiliar with syndication, and who is not familiar with our lousy business, is that they may quit, and that's embarrassing for us. So that's why syndicates like to have cartoonists who are working for newspapers, because they don't have to worry about them saying, hey, this syndication business is lousy, I'm going to quit, and you look like a fool for promoting me. I'll add to that the fact that the newspapers are not asking for more content. Makes it tough. That said, if it's what you want to do, you got to do it. And I can't imagine doing anything else because I love being part of the public debate. I think I've got the best job in the world. But you can see that I kind of jumped through some hoops to try to make this business work for me. I've been laid off from newspapers that went out of business and you just, in my case, my port in the storm is doing the syndicate. Instead of having a newspaper. Sign Matrix, can you make me... Oh, you made me the most widely syndicated editorial cartoonist. Excellent. Thank you for that change. I'm not sure I'm happy with my Hillary. I don't think I like her nose, and I don't think I like this eye. Oh, and thank you for the new follow, a doodling octopus. Thank you. I do appreciate the follows. I need follows. I am, to my knowledge, I'm the only streaming editorial cartoonist. And I'm eager to do a bit of proof of concept here. See if we can make this work. And if we can, I think we'll see some more editorial cartoonists try the streaming. It's nice when they put me on the Jumbotron. I appreciate that. Thank you, Twitch. All right, I'm going to rethink her eyeballs. I'm going to rethink her nose and her eyeballs. So I'm not satisfied with either nose or eyeballs. You can probably hear, I drop a lot of pencils on the floor. Floor is full of pencils. All right, Hillary's eyeballs and nose. So just to recap, folks, this is a Valentine's Day cartoon. And it's drawn because young women voters are in large numbers going to Bernie rather than Hillary. And Hillary's raison d'etre, her argument, is that she's wants to be the first woman president and how important that is, and she stands up for women's rights and all that, which I'm sure she does. But her young women's are going to Bernie. And as I draw it, it's because Cupid's pointing them there. But that's just because it's pointing out the problem in a cartoon that works for Valentine's Day. Okay, Hillary's nose. I don't think I like that. I have to think a bit more about her nose. When I struggle with something, the answer is usually to make it cartoonier. So let's do that. Is that looking like her? A little bit. I think she's not looking very good, and I'm going to need to improve her. Let's erase the whole friggin' Hillary face and start her over. That's one thing that's nice about Duraline. I think I like her mouth. Duraline is very forgiving of the erasing. The worst problem that I'll have is that I'll pick up pencil from underneath. You can see there's some pencil on the other side of this. Hillary has this history of very dark, heavy eyebrows, almost a unibrow, which she doesn't anymore. She has groomed her eyebrows. Anonymous writes, "Hey, excuse me, sir. This be live or restream?" This be live, sir. But I am a little bit delayed. So, keep that in mind if I'm slow to respond to your comments here. Yep, this be live. You can see all of my struggles and errors in real time. I'm going to make her eyes bigger. It's kind of funny. He's looking unhappy. Nobody's gonna wonder if that's Hillary, huh? I think I've got Hillary. So I keep dropping pencils on the floor. It's kind of funny. Oh, thank you, Geek Techio. I appreciate the follow. Also, Zakagna, thank you so much. All you folks that are watching me because of the Jumbotron, come on and follow me. You'll never find me again unless you follow me now. I'm not sure I want her to have that big earring. Yeah, I'm going to get rid of the big earring. That's just a little too silly. Live or restream? I hadn't really thought about that. Thank you. Anyway, I do really appreciate all these follows. You folks are very nice to follow. The number of followers is kind of the measure of proof of concept of whether this can work for editorial cartoonists. And I'm eager to prove the concept. Going to be hard to get other cartoonists to do this, I think. I'd give it a try. But, you know, it takes a little bit of bravery to show all your errors. I certainly have lots of errors that I worry about showing. Cagna writes, do you think that Trump will win the elections? Oh, you're Italian. I think it's looking pretty good for him right now. Possible that he'll win. Also possible that Hillary can implode and her email controversy could get worse. So things could work out for Trump and for Bernie. A little bad luck for Hillary. Hillary, as a cartoon character, is a nice cartoon character because people know all about her. You don't have to explain her. All of the stories are things that people know, which makes for a great cartoon character, because what you want to do with a cartoon character is character humor, where the character acting like you expect the character to act is rewarding. It's like the gag. It's like Lucy pulling the football away from Charlie Brown. It took years for you to learn that Lucy's always going to pull away the football. And so then once you learn that, seeing her pull away the football is rewarding. Well, so it is with all kinds of character humor. And you know Hillary's character already. So all those years learning that Lucy's going to throw the football, going to pull away the football, all of that is in the bank with Hillary. We know all that stuff. So that's good. Judas Mata 1 writes, in the Draw the Angel Try What Hillary Fall in Love with the Grandpa? I'm not quite sure how to respond to that one. Fall in love with the grandpa. Aren't they the same age? All of this cartoon is a commentary on young women voters who are far and away favoring Bernie Sanders over Hillary Clinton at the same time that Hillary Clinton claims to be the voice of women. We had some interesting quotes recently from Gloria Steinem and Madeleine Albright. Madeleine Albright saying there's a special place in hell for women who don't vote for Hillary. Gloria Steinem saying these young girls only like Bernie because they want to get dates. And there's more dates at the The Bernie rallies. Completely dismissive of real misogynistic kind of statements. But that's the point, and the point is to draw a Valentine's Day cartoon because the editors are nuts for holidays. The Phoebe writes, face palms. Now I can't talk. Face palms. Face palms, is that like this? Face palm? Don't know, face palm. Well, I'm getting close to finishing here. What happens when I finish here is that I'm going to take a 15-minute break and scan this, get it into Photoshop, and then color it. The 15-minute break is just because the process of sticking this in the scanner and assembling it in Photoshop. Palm to face is something that does not lend itself to my camera setup. And I need to break it up every couple of hours. If I'd been doing this for a couple of hours, look at this. 2 hours and 35 minutes on the final drawing, 2 hours on the rough sketch for this, and you saw it here. Oh, I didn't do the... This is kind of important to the gag. The sound from Cupid. Kind of necessary, huh? Otherwise, you don't know he's doing the raspberry. And thank you for the kind words, the Phoeb. This is how you spell, right? Oh, and Geek Techio, thank you for following. I appreciate that. Do I like his wing? This is all the last stuff I'm going to do before I scan this. No more drawing once I scan it. So, am I happy with this? All right, I think I'm kind of there. That's where we are with it. This is going to be the final line art. And I'm going to scan it. And I'm going to come back in 15 minutes. Oh, in Italian, it's P-R-R-R. Or poof. P, you need, I think I need a P at the beginning rather than a B. I don't know. Psy Matrix writes that Bill Watterson used THBPBPTHPT. Okay. I don't have a good answer for that problem. It looks like there are multiple solutions available. Okay. This is... I think I'm going to scan this and come back in 15 minutes. So, I ask your indulgence to come back and wait for me, because I'm going to spend at least an hour and a half coloring this puppy. So, I'll bid you all goodbye. I'm going to scan it. I'm going to come back in 15 minutes and sit here for another hour and a half or 2 hours coloring this bad boy. And I think that's something you need to see. You can't have invested this much time in it and then just leave before you see the color. My goodness. So thank you, folks. And I'm off and coming right back, because I'm not really gone. So...